Yes, you can play native port of Shadow Warrior on your modded 3DS. Today we are looking at how is it possible, how to install it, and how to get the most out of it. So, let's get cracking! First, how is it even possible? It is possible thanks to Mr. who made a 3DS port. This 3DS port is based on a Jonathan Fowler's Shadow Warrior port, aka JFSW, which is basically an updated version of original MS-DOS game for modern systems. PS Vita also received the port of JFSW, and all comrades are loving it. This 3DS port is as good as that one. So, how to install it?
First, create a folder on your microSD card, then copy over some files, and then run either CIA or .3DSX.
Okay, so this is my microSD card, my 3DS folder, my JSFW folder, and here you need especially this file, sw.grp, and all the music tracks in OGG format. Remember, MIDI is not supported, only OGG. That's the full folder. The size of the game is not that large, it's about 110 megabytes, and that's full game.
So your folder is ready, now go to the official GitHub release page. Address looks like this, link is down below. And here you go to releases and download the latest one, that's this one, 0.03. You either download CIA or .3DSX. If you install CIA, you're gonna have also icon on your home screen and you can only run .3DSX via your Homebrew browser. So there is no icon on your home screen. Because of that, I always prefer .cia, if it's available, of course.
Now we can finally play the game. Ideally on I'm a tiny grasshopper difficulty, because the game's difficulty is hardcore times 4. And you can be easily discouraged, and we don't want that. We want you to have as much fun as possible. So before we're gonna play the game, we're gonna go into the options. And here there is a bunch of settings to play with. First, there is a screen menu. You can change screen size, even for the full screen. We can change border tile. Brightness doesn't work, I think. We can also scale the panel, larger and smaller. Here we can set resolution, but this is what we want, 400 by 240. Then we can go to sound menu. We can play with sound settings, turn off music, turn off ambience and things like that. Here we can toggle bunch of things like messages, shadows, auto run, crosshair, auto aiming, voxel sprites, level stats. I have everything enabled because that's how I like it. Then the most important, the input menu. Here in the joystick button setup, you can set all the buttons, what is everything doing, A fire, B crouch, X jump, Y open. Here are triggers. Here is a D-pad. Then another very important joystick axis setup. Here you can set axis scale. You can invert axis. You can set dead zone, saturation. So this is axis 0. I think the only one I have changed is the last one, axis 3. And I put it as inverted because otherwise when I went up, it was going down with the C-stick. You can toggle however you want, but this was fairly okay for me to play it on the default, just to put it on inverted, the last one. Now this is crouch, this is jump, this is attack. ZL and ZR are for changing weapons. Now we can kill some monsters. It is a first-person shooter, so you strafe with left joystick and look around with C-stick. I'm not exactly sure if it works on old 3DS. It might, but you know you're gonna be missing C-stick. And you kinda need it for looking around, so not sure how the playability is gonna be in there.
It's Chuck from the future. Looks like I figured out how to control it on your old 3DS. With a touch. Weird, I haven't tried it, I know. But now we know. You're gonna be strafing like this and aiming like this. It's not ideal, but I think it's doable. C-stick is certainly better than that.
Now let's take the Uzi. Kawabunga! Okay, now we got Uzi machine, submachine gun. Now we can kill some monster. We got a crosshair. Oh, it's actually going pretty fast. Let's take a katana. The playability is quite good. I like the game. The controls are not terrible. Maybe a little bit, you know, we play with the axes, but even like this, it's actually very good. Unlock doors, kill monsters. Oh, I'm dead. So, because of this, you wanna choose I'm a tiny grasshopper difficulty. And even if you choose it, you see, I'm dead already.
Also, just to remind you, there is a config file like in almost every port. Here you can set bunch of settings like screen width, screen height. This is full screen. And bunch of other things like sound and most importantly controls. But I think you can set all of this also in the game settings, in the options. So you don't really need to go in here. Just so you know, it's also available, you know, not just in the options, but also in the config file.
This port runs at full speed. There are no issues. I like Shadow Warrior. And I'm super glad 3DS and even Vita have received it in its full glory. Would be nice if the bottom screen is also somehow utilized. Maybe if this bar is displayed in here, that would be neat. Or maybe also the map. Not really sure. But this looks like a good idea that when you put it on a full screen, then this bar would be displayed in here. That would be quite nice utilization. Either way, this is a great port. Certainly an essential, a must install piece of homebrew for your 3DS and for your Vita too.
In my previous video, I was looking at the native 3DS port of Fallout 1. If you want to get it running, check it out right here. And there are many more amazing ports and homebrews that we're going to be looking in the upcoming episodes. Stay tuned, subscribe, like. Thanks to you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.